Today's lesson is about services of the old age homes. This lesson is about the services of old age homes provided to the inmates, such as accommodation, medical and physical care, recreational facilities, income generation and general services. And also this lesson examines the problems of the older people in the institutional setting. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to know the services of the old age homes, and you can describe about the lifestyles of elderly in old age homes and understand the problems of the elderly in old age homes. Institutional living among the aged is becoming an increasingly common form of living in some societies, especially among the oldest of the old. Old age homes are gaining importance because, as it is generally observed, industrialization and urbanization have made people to opt for small families. There are more than 1,000 of old age homes in India. Most of them offers free accommodation. Some homes work on a payment basis, depending on the type of and quality of services they offered. Apart from food, shelter and medical amenities, old age homes also provide yoga classes to senior citizens. Old age homes also provide access to telephones and other forms of communication so that residents may keep in touch with their loved ones. Against this background, let me discuss about the general or basic services of the old age homes in India. Nutritious meal. An old age home needs to provide a balanced diet that perfectly benefits the older people and which is rich in calcium, proteins and vitamins and low on fat. Green vegetables and adequate milk is provided too for a fit and healthy living of older people. As age advances, due to the decline in appetite and sensitivity to taste and smell, their intake of food decreases, leading to a decline in health. In this situation, adequate mineral intake in diet should be ensured. Thus, intake of good diet will help a person to live a happy and healthy life during aging. There are no specific dietary rules for senior citizens. Without enough teeth, they can chew foods. As people grow older, they usually eat vegetarian food due to the teeth problems. A balanced diet will go a long way in ensuring a healthy life for old age. Proper nutrition is vital for the aged people in order to restore their health. Hygienic environment. Old age homes need to maintain a very routine in order to have a good hygiene conditions. Bed sheets and blankets are properly cleaned and consistently changed. Pure drinking water facilities accessible to older people. The hygiene and cleanliness of the kitchen is also taken care of really well. A clean and homely atmosphere needs to be provided for elderly in homes. Medical care. Old age homes are highly conscious when it comes to the medical health of the elder people. So they need very efficient medical facilities to ensure the best health of elderly. Doctors have to be present at homes in case of any urgent medical care. Old age homes also need physiotherapists, which is extremely helpful to the people suffering from fractured legs, bone or muscle break, paralysis and especially arthritis. This helps in easing the pain without the harmful side effects of consuming painkiller. Telephone. Telephone facility is one of the basic facilities available in the old age homes so that its inmates can contact with their family members as and when they are required. Caregivers. Caregivers are self-identified individuals who provide unpaid or informal care for the sick, disabled and are cognitively impaired older adults. Many of the old age homes are providing caregiver support to the older people. Old age home staff must consist of highly dedicated people who are sensitive and sentimental towards the old aged. They take care of them like their families. Recreational activities. Recreational activities and reading facilities such as televisions, newspapers and books need to be available in the old age homes. Depending on the extent of physical activity of the residents, other facilities for the active sports like carom boards, chess, ludo, tennis, table tennis can be provided. Spiritual awakening sessions are like bhajans and satsangs need to be conducted in the old age homes. Recreational activities are very important in old age homes. In fact, that the inmates suffer from multiple mental miseries make recreation a truly inevitable aspect of life in the institutional care. It can alleviate depression and several other mental disorders of the inmates. To keep the mental health strong, the inmates of old age homes can be given counseling. Religious prayers and meditations are essential for old people to keep their mental health sound and proper. Meditation is said to be a good tonic for the preservation of mental health, away from depression and anxiety. Loneliness and depression can be avoided by means of meditations and prayers. Regular exercise. Yoga and general regular exercise are essential for all the aged people. The benefits are plenty, proper blood circulation in order to function the organs properly. Regular exercise keeps their body in a normal condition. Exercise would definitely help them to lead a normal life and strengthen the bone. The institutions need to encourage their inmates to do regular exercises to reduce their hypertension, cholesterol, and blood sugar. Daycare services. Daycare, a community facility that frail older adults living at home can attend several hours each day. Facilities based on the health rehabilitation model provide individualized therapy plans. Those based on the social model engage the participants in social and psychotherapeutic activities. Daycare centers for the elderly can provide the facility where the aged may spend their day in the company of others rather than be alone at home. The fit and capable in the group could get certification of the helping the unfit and disabled. The daycare center should have the outdoor medical facility, physiotherapy center, recreation facility, religious discourses, etc. Some of the elderly enjoy indulging in some income generating activities more for recreation than for the earning. The first daycare center for the people with dementia started in Cochin, India in 1996. Geriatric care. Some of the old age homes also provide geriatric care for the improving the health conditions of the elderly. Apart from this, the Government of India launched a national program for the healthcare of elderly in the year 2010 to address the health related problems of the elderly people. The basic aim of the national program for the healthcare of the elderly is to provide separate, specialized and comprehensive healthcare to the senior citizens at various levels of state healthcare delivery system, including outreach services. The major components of the national program for the healthcare of elderly are establishment of Department of Geriatric in identified medical institutions as regional geriatric centers for the different regions of the country and to provide dedicated health facilities in district hospitals, community health centers, primary health care centers and sub-centers. Under this program, 20 regional geriatric centers are implementing the program all over the country. Following facilities are being provided under this program. Geriatric clinic, that is specialized outpatient department for the elderly, includes the 30-bedded geriatric ward for the inpatient care and dedicated beds for the elderly patients in the various specialties like surgery, orthopedics, psychiatry, urology, ophthalmology and neurology, etc. Laboratory investigation required for elderly with a specific sample collection center in the outpatient department. Geriatric outpatient department and 10-bed geriatric ward at the district hospitals and bi-weekly geriatric clinic at the community health centers. Weekly geriatric clinic at primary healthcare centers. Provision of aids and appliances at sub-centers. Home healthcare services will be provided for the regional geriatric centers for population with age above 75 years. The services will include visit by a team of paramedical health professionals, one nurse and or one physiotherapist, once in 2 weeks to the homes of the patients receiving treatment from the outpatient department or the discharged from the ward but not in a position to visit hospital, and provision of nursing care and clinical evaluation, etc. Administration of parenteral medication and training of family members in feeding, bathing, wound care, bed sore prevention, etc. And rehabilitation and training of activities of daily living, physiotherapy, etc. Home care. Home care is a care that allows a person with special needs stay in their home. It might be for people who are getting older or chronically ill, recovering from surgery or disabled. Home care services include personal care such as help with the bathing, washing hair or getting dressed. Homemaking such as cleaning, yard work, laundry, cooking or delivery meals, and health care such as having a home health advisor come to your home. And helpline and counseling services. A helpline for senior citizens enables them to reach out for help and assistance against abuse. It is also helpful in information dissemination, thus creating awareness among the senior citizens in a number of matters. Distress calls from the elders seeking assistance are handled by a qualified social worker. Helplines volunteers trained in basic counseling are sent to the senior citizens' residence on a fact-finding mission. Thereafter, appropriate assistance is provided to the aggrieved caller. At the time, specific assistance is required for an effective and speedy redressal of grievances. The older persons, irrespective of the type of the old age homes, were generally satisfied with the services. But many of those in the middle income and moderate pay and stay old age homes showed dissatisfaction with the quality of services. It is necessary that some of the basic facilities like toilets, drinking water and food should be given extra consideration. Moreover, the regional character of the residents should be taken into account while planning and preparing food in old age homes. Recreation is a very important aspect of life. The old age homes by and large had very little space for recreation, which led to the vicious circle of non-participation, boredom and pessimism. The data also shows that quite a significant percentage of elderly were uncertain and worried about their future. So they felt nervous and concerned. Their worries were due to their lonely existence, and their solitary existence was responsible for their unhappiness even after shifting into the old age homes. Various empirical studies on old age homes conducted in Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Punjab, Delhi, Gujarat revealed the following trends. Most of the old age homes were either free, set up by the respective governments, philanthropic organizations, or pay and stay type, set up by the completely unregulated private operators. Most of the homes were set up as a response to the locally felt need and not a part of a well thought out of plan. In some homes, residents were expected to pay more compared to the facilities offered, and in some others, small payment entitled them to better facilities. None of the homes had permanent medical facility. The arrangements arranged for daily to weekly visits by the doctor, but in all old age homes, the cost of medicines was wholly borne by the resident. There was no provision for the very sick and the bedridden older persons. Common health problems reported by the residents included blood pressure, rheumatism and joint pains, diabetes, asthma, heart disease, hearing problem, paralysis, etc. Socioeconomic characteristics of inmates living in old age homes. Most of the residents in old age homes were below 80 years of age, mostly widow or widowers. Those who never married, people with low and medium educational qualifications and hence lower earning ability. Most of them did not work, not many contributed to the chores in the old age homes. Most of the residents were living in the home out of the compulsion and would rather go back to the family. The major reason for living in the old age homes was lack of resources and domestic conflict and the dearth of the caregivers in the family. The reasons could be empirically traced to the different segments. For example, the poor had no resources, were snatched away by the children and had no caregivers. The economically better off had domestic conflict, male cited practical difficulties and female cited emotional reasons for moving to an institution. Very few residents cited desire for independent living as a reason for moving into the old age home. In charity old age homes, literacy levels were low. Elderly women were less educated than men. Relatively better educated, higher caste people lived mostly in paid old age homes. Only those who were defrauded by their children lived in free facilities. The number of children was inversely proportional to the transfer into the old age homes. That is, lesser the number of children, more the chances of moving into the old age home. Most of the residents have lived in the extended families before moving into the old age homes, and many wanted to go back. But old age homes where people had lived for the longer duration, they were happy to be in the institution as they had developed their own social network there. Though old age homes provide various services to the elderly, there are variations depending upon their objectives, priorities and financial resources. Old age homes across India are providing various services to the older people as institutional care with and without the financial aid of the government. Problems of the older people in old age homes. Older people are getting all the facilities in old age homes, even though they are facing a lot of physical, psychological and social problems. Elderly are susceptible to the variety of physical and mental disorders. Arthritis, hypertension, breathing problems, indigestion, etc. are the major physical problems of the inmates have. They isolate from their homes and community. Thus, they are facing a lot of psychological problems such as loneliness, depression, stress, anxiety, etc. Tendency towards death is more common in the elderly lives in old age homes. Many research studies reveal that psychological problems are more elderly lives in the old age homes than the elderly resides with their families. Depression is the most common among them. Symptoms of depression include lack of interest in activities, sadness, irritability, loss of memory, inability to concentrate, confusion or disorientation, thoughts of death or suicide, change in appetite and sleep patterns, persistent fatigue, tiredness, aches and other unexpected explainable physical problems, dementias and pseudo-dementias, etc. Socially, they are unable to mingle with the co-residents. The old age homes are often called home away from home. There is a significant adjustment problems with the other inmates. They were taken care by the old age homes. Counselors were appointed to treat them. Sometimes depression can also be masked and presented mainly with the various bodily complaints such as pains and excessive preoccupation with the bodily functions. At times, depression in old age people is associated with serious physical illness and may show a blend of depression, anxiety, irritability and attention seeking behavior. After ruling out the presence of any physical illness, the depression can be treated through a course of antidepressants under the careful supervision of a psychiatrist. And psychotherapy is a powerful tool to help the person identify and deal with the life stresses or other conflicts related to self-esteem and self-concept. Participation of the residents in the running of the home. The residents should be encouraged to participate in the day-to-day activities of the home, which may be anything from cooking to maintaining the cleanliness of the home. They could also periodically organize celebrations of various festivals and social events. Most of the old age homes are encouraged residents to do gardening also. Designing of old age homes. Old age homes could be the dormitory type, independent rooms or cottages depending on the social and economic status of those who are going to live in the homes. The room should be well ventilated. All facilities in the home should be at the ground floor level as much as possible. If upper floors have to be built, then a sloping ramp has to be provided, which would also facilitate easy passage of wheelchair when needed. The toilets and bathroom should have a rough flooring so that the elders do not slip. Suitable railings should be provided for support. A room should be set apart where sick people needing short-term treatment could be housed. Recreation rooms and rooms for medical care should be built. Who needs to work in the old age homes? A home for the aged will need an administrator who will be responsible for the running of the home. The supporting staff such as clerks, cashier cum accountant, nursing staff, attenders, maids and cook are the basic required staff for the efficient running of an old age home. A medical officer will be needed to attend to the health needs of the inmates. If the home is very close to hospital where emergencies can be treated, then it may not be enough to avail the services of the doctor who works there part-time. A nutritionist can play an important role by providing special attention to the nutritional requirements of the residents. At least a part-time nutrition should be appointed. A professionally qualified social worker is an essential member of the team of personnel. Wherever possible, nursing staff and healthcare workers trained in geriatric care should be appointed. What are the requirements for medical care in such an institution like old age homes? All medicines and medical accessories that may be needed for treatment of the residents should be stored as per the advice of a senior physician. For example, oxygen cylinders, suction contraption, intravenous sets should be readily available. Drugs should be replaced periodically considering to their expiry date. Transport facilities should be available in case of there is any rush to them to the hospital for the intensive care. Old age homes are meant for senior citizens who are unable to stay with their families or destitute. States in India such as Delhi, Kerala, Maharashtra and West Bengal have developed good quality of old age homes. These old age homes have special medical facilities for senior citizens such as mobile healthcare systems, ambulances, nurses and provision of well-balanced meals. Most of the old age homes offer free accommodation. Some homes work on a payment basis depending on the type and quality of services offered. Apart from food, shelter and medical amenities, old age homes also provide yoga classes to the senior citizens. Old age homes also provide access to telephones, and other forms of communication so that residents may keep in touch with their loved ones. Some old age homes have daycare centers. These centers only take care of senior citizens during the day. For older people who have nowhere to go and no one to support them, old age homes provide a safe haven. These homes also create a family-like atmosphere among the residents. Senior citizens experience a sense of security and friendship when they share their joys and sorrows with each other. For older people who have nowhere to go and no one to support them, old age homes provide a safe haven. These homes also create a family-like atmosphere among the residents. Senior citizens experience a sense of security and friendship when they share their joys and sorrows with each other.